Good morning. For our scripture this morning, I'm going to read some excerpts from the beginning of the book of Revelation. It's from Revelation chapter 2, verse 1 to chapter 3, verse 22, but I'm only going to read certain verses. John writes, "God said to me, 'Write this to Ephesus, to the angel of the church. I see what you've done, your hard work, your refusal to quit. I know you can't stomach evil, that you weed out apostolic pretenders. I know your persistence, your courage in my cause, that you never wear out. But you walked away from your first love. Why? What's going on with you anyway? Do you have any idea how far you've fallen? A Lucifer fall. Write this to Smyrna, to the angel of the church. I can see your pain and poverty, constant pain, dire poverty. But I also see your wealth, and I hear the lie and the claims of those who pretend to be good believers, who in fact belong to Satan's crowd. Write this to Pergamum, to the angel of the church. I see where you live, right under the shadow of Satan's throne. But you continue boldly in my name. You never once denied my name, even when the pressure was worst, when there were martyred Antipas, my witness who stayed faithful to me on Satan's turf. Write this to Thyatira, to the angel of the church. I see everything you're doing for me. Impressive. The love and the faith, the service and persistence. Yes, very impressive. You get better at it every day. Write this to Sardis, to the angel of the church. I see right through your work. You have a reputation for vigor and zest, but you're dead. Stone dead. Write this to Philadelphia, to the angel of the church. I see what you've done. Now see what I've done. I've opened a door before you that no one can slam shut. You don't have much strength. I know that. You used what you had to keep my word. You didn't deny me when times were rough. Write to Laodicea, to the angel of the church. I know you inside and out, and find little to my liking. You're not cold. You're not hot. Far better to be cold or hot. You're stale. You're stagnant. You make me want to vomit. You brag, 'I'm rich. I've got it made. I need nothing from anyone.' Oblivious that in fact you're a pitiful, blind beggar, threadbare and homeless. Look at me. I stand at the door. I knock. If you hear me call and open the door, I'll come right in and sit down to supper with you. Are your ears awake? Listen. Listen to the wind words, the Spirit blowing through the churches." Here ends the readings. This was written by a writer named John, who was the bishop of some churches in what is now Asia Minor or Turkey. And you'll notice that he's writing to the angel of the churches. And there's this, it kind of names that every angel, every congregation has a church or a spirit, kind of an identity that is God-given. And so we like to think about the angel of First Lutheran Church. What is the angel that is here? And when a congregation can identify and name that angel, then they can grow into more and be more of what God intends for them to be. The council for the last several months, really, has been at work praying and listening to the congregation in order to better discern the unique spirit, the unique angel of First Lutheran Church. Now, this is not about creating or coming up with a good idea of what the angel should be. It's really about listening, about the and trying to discern the angel that is here, the spirit that is here, and really trying to name and claim it. So many of you were involved in the values card exercise that we did at the AGM in November. And so that yielded, a certain number of values and kind of priorities and things like that. It was still a pretty long list. And so at the retreat that we had in at the end of February, the council spent time kind of distilling that down and saying, okay, what is this trying to describe? How can we crystallize this into some core values that are our best shot at naming and claiming the spirit of First Lutheran Church? And so this morning, even though I'm not there, your council members are going to be presenting the four core values that we discerned and talking about them. So I invite you to welcome them and listen to them as they share the core values for First Lutheran Church.
Thank you. Thank you. Yes. Thank you.